بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Dear cadets of class 7, Assalamu alaikum and good day to you all. Hope you all are fine at your respective houses. Dear boys, you know we are going through a really tough time. We are being affected by COVID-19 disease, that means coronavirus. And it has made our life miserable. So my suggestion for you is, please keep yourself confined at your houses. Don't go outside and don't roam around the locality. Please take care of yourself as well as your family members. And make the people aware of coronavirus if it is possible. So dear boys, today we are going to discuss chapter 7, that means growth of child in a family. It is an important chapter of your textbook. In the last class, we discussed chapter 7, that means climate of Bangladesh, the last portion, lesson 4 and lesson 5. And today, our learning outcomes are, after the class, you will be able to explain the concept of nature of family, compare the rural family with the urban family, analyze the role of changing concept of family in the socialization of a child, describe the roles of different members of family and mutual relationship in the socialization of a family, of a child, inculcate human and social virtues and thus qualify to develop social relations and act in a disciplined manner. And today, there are some terms which will be frequently used in today's lecture. These are family, nuclear family or satellite family or a small family, then joint or extended family, rural and urban families, changing trend of families, and lastly, socialization of children. Dear boys, at first I would like to brief you about family. You should know the definition of family. Family is the first place for the growth of a child. The socialization of the child starts from the family. Family has reached to what it is today through evolution over ages. Whatsoever the background was, the most vital institution of human society is family. It is the smallest unit of the society. This chapter describes nature of family, socialization of children, and other related matters. So, before going to the explanation of the whole chapter, I would like to define family. As I have already said, family is a social institution, and you know we the human being are social being. We live in the society. Human race has evolved from the family, and with them, the society has also advanced. When some people are bound together by virtue of marriage, relationship or parental descent, and they live together, it is known as family, which constitutes a social institution. This is the definition of family. This definition is given in your textbook. Please memorize this. It often comes in your exams. Next, concept and nature of family. Some other points. Each member of a family has their own specific responsibilities. Members of a family are tied deep with each other. Affection, love, and such kind of emotions are keys to this bond. Family plays its role as the primary institution of the society. The most important among them are maintenance of the clan and socialization. Now, all societies are constituted with families, but the nature of family is not the same in every society. The nature of family is also different in characteristics. A few major types of family have been given below. Actually, there are different types of families, such as nuclear family, joint family, extended family, single mother family, single father family, stepfather family, stepmother family. There are so on. So I will not discuss the in detailed types of families, but I would only discuss the two terms which are discussed in your textbook only. So in your textbook, there are two types of families. These are nuclear family or a small family, and it is also called satellite family. And another is joint family. In the next slide, we will be discussing about the difference between nuclear and joint family. Now let us define what is nuclear family and joint family. Nuclear family, a nuclear family consists of husband, wife, and unmarried children. When the children become adults, they start their own families, then a new nuclear family starts. In urban Bangladesh, nuclear families are more in number. So what we have understood from this, we have understood that nuclear families are small families where there will be only the father, the mother, and the unmarried children. And mostly these nuclear families are found in the urban area, that means in town area or city area. And joint families, on the other hand, a number of families basing on blood relation together make a joint family. This kind of family is made with the parents of the bread earner of family, his brothers and sisters with their respective children or grandparents, paternal uncles and aunts. Such kind of family are available in rural Bangladesh and in India. So when we live with our close relatives together, then it will be called as joint family. And joint families are large in size and family members are more. And normally this type of families are found in the rural areas of Bangladesh. Now let us distinguish between nuclear and joint family. Definition. I have already defined it. Let us define again. The family which consists of husband, wife, and unmarried children is called a nuclear family. And an extended family, typically consisting of three or more generations and their spouses living together as a single household, is called a joint family. And nuclear families are available in urban or city areas, and joint families are available in rural areas or village areas. And what are the strength of nuclear family and joint family? Strength, that means the positive side. Financially stable, both parents usually work now. Children raised in a stable parenting situation, consistency, emphasis on health and education, focus on communication. And as per joint family is concerned, things like respect and care for the elderly are important. More family around to help with chores, childcare, in cases of emergencies, etc. And thirdly, social support. And what are the weaknesses? The weaknesses of nuclear family are exclusion of extended family can lead to isolation and stress. Can struggle with conflict resolution. Nuclear families can become too child-focused, resulting in self-centered children and families neglecting other important things. Financial, and as per joint family is concerned, financial issues can occur if parents are supporting several other adults and children without any extra income, lack of privacy depending on the living environment. So from this table, we have come to know about the differences between nuclear family and joint family. This has not been mentioned in your textbook, but for your better understanding and further clarification, I have put it here. Hope you will read this and you will try to understand this, which family is important. I think both are important, but in respect of place, this may vary. Now, based on rural and urban, the families are also divided into two categories. These are rural families and urban families. This table has been made from the textbook. Rural families, that means the families which are found in the rural areas, that means village areas. A rural society has majority of joint families. I have already discussed that in the rural areas, mostly joint families are found, and in the urban families or urban areas, the nuclear or satellite or small families are found. In the rural families, main profession is agriculture, and in the urban families, most of the people are engaged in different kinds of jobs. And in the rural families, that means in joint family, the senior most male member is the head of the family. A woman doesn't have much leading role in the family, and they don't have their own job normally. They work in the houses, that means they are engaged in household activities. But in the urban families, that means in nuclear family, as the family is small, and many a times we see that both father and mother, they are engaged in different kinds of jobs, and the children are brought up in the houses by the housemaids sometimes. So let us see what is said here. The control of family among the educated middle class and upper class in town areas doesn't lie with the husband only. Wives are given due importance in decision making by the urban husbands. Now, changing trends of families and socialization of children, we will divide this lesson 3 into two categories. Firstly, we will discuss about changing trends of families, that means the nature of or system of the changes of families in our country. And then we will discuss in the latter part the socialization of children. Both are very important. I would like to request you to listen to the lectures very carefully. At first, changing trends of families. What do we mean by this? Changing family means families created due to change of nature of family pattern. Families created due to change of nature of family pattern. Hope you got it. For example, urban nuclear families are created as a result of evolution of rural joint families. And what are the reasons of changing trend of families? There are some reasons such as huge population, family feud, that means quarrel between families, divorce, employment of women, etc. Besides, roles of family members of both rural and urban families are also changing. A close look at our own families will confirm this. If we confirm our own family and our relatives' families, we will understand this. Was everybody, including father, mother, uncle, aunt, grandfather, grandmother, and cousins, used to live jointly? Now the changed nature has reached villages too. Satellite or small families, that mean nuclear families, never think about anything but their own happiness, ease, and comfort. That means, what are the main aim of satellite or small families or nuclear families? Nuclear families only thinks about their own happiness, their own ease, and their own comfort. But in the joint family, we can share our griefs, we can share our happiness, and we can live together with our dear and loved ones. But in present day's perspective, there is no other option rather than nuclear families. In the city areas, it is not possible to live with all our relatives, that means our closed ones. That's why we are bound to live in a nuclear family because of our job nature, because of our present trend. This is affecting socialization of children. That means these nuclear families, this family, one of the negative impact of nuclear family is this is affecting the socialization of children. As the child, he doesn't get enough opportunity to mix up with others. That means with his grandfather or grandmother, his uncle, aunt, he confined himself in a single family, and his proper grooming is not possible because of this. Then socialization of children, another important thing. And what does socialization mean? The way children grow in a society is called their socialization. Very important. I repeat, the way children grow in a society is called their socialization. Memorize this thing. A child takes birth and grows within a family. Whatever they learn, their parents and other members of the family during their growth is considered as their socialization. It is a process that continues from cradle to the grave. The first influence in socialization of children is from family. The family plays a vital role in the primary education. Actually, the parents lead a child to the world of learning. That is the reason family is called an important educational unit. In combined families, children are used to be involved in family profession from their early years. Therefore, family used to be the center of education of children. But nowadays, this role of family has been taken over by other institutions. Children are being educated in general schools, technical schools, etc. This tells that family does not anymore have the role it is used to play previously. It is affecting the socialization of children. Family's role in giving religious education to the children is also important. The religious minded people of Bangladesh are well aware about providing religious education to children. Usually it takes place within the family. The parents, grandparents, or the family members used to teach religious values and morality to the children. With the changing time, that role has been weakened and has been affecting socialization of children. The recent trend is to teach religion to the children by means of cassette, video, or employing a maulavi, that means a huzur. This is the obstructing the growth of true religious spirit among children. Religion is no more able to create humanitarian and moral values, which is supposed to do. So far, rearing children was regarded a unique responsibility of family, but society of present Bangladesh sees rise of various institutions in this respect. They take the responsibility of rearing children with care. They are more available in urban areas. For example, children of working parents are brought up in children's home, that means in daycare home or some other means. The relationship between children and members of a joint family is based on interpersonal communication and behavior. These interpersonal exchanges acted as means of social education for children, as the elders used to give them ideas of cooperation, patience, sympathy, sense of security, equal partnership, etc., through their actions. But these are not possible in the nuclear families because the children, they don't have opportunity to be with their other family members. This used to build up the spirit of children. Many responsibilities of family have been taken over by various social and government organizations. Responsibilities like education, recreation, economic production, etc. are not that much carried out by family anymore. Recreational activities like visiting parks, zoos, museums, etc. are not done by families. However, birthday celebrations, marriage ceremonies, visiting relatives, watching television, etc. are still done at family level. Now, lesson 4, role of family members and impact of their mutual relationships in socialization of children. Family is vital in socialization. The good and bad habits of children are results of socialization in family. Family gives rise to values like social values, citizen conscience, cooperation, fraternity, self-sacrifice, and love in a child. We will learn about roles of family members in socialization of children and impact of mutual relations in this lesson. A relationship is built up through the attitude and behavior of family members towards a child. This leaves a mark on the mind of children. The nearest human beings to a child are their parents. Again, among the parents, mother is privileged to be the nearer. As a result, socialization of a child begins in the hands of the mother. So the mother is the first teacher, first mentor for a child. A mother builds up the food habit of a child. The child starts to learn language through their mother. Whatever food the mother provides for the child and makes them eat will determine the food habit and attitude of that child. Mother lulls the child to sleep. Lulls means the song which is sung to make the children sleep. Mother teaches the child letters, words, rhymes, etc. All of these affect the child's mind. Their behavior and attitude later will reflect all these. The father earns the living for the family. Mothers in some families also do so, but normally in our country, the father is the bread earner. They have to apply certain rules and regulations to run their family. This independent behavior and values affects this child's socialization. You may follow the roles your parents and siblings play in your family. You will find that your elder brothers and sisters give you support, sympathy, love, and care in various activities. You also learn sense of discipline, rules and regulations, etc. from them. Your behavior in life in future will reflect this. Attitudes, behaviors of grandparents, uncles, aunts, and cousins also influence the behavioral pattern of child. These all together create a strength and strengthen the perception about self in a child. Proper socialization of a child needs good family environment. The first and foremost need for a good family environment is good relationship between father and mother. Besides, some other aspects such as avoidance of quarrels and tension in the family, having and showing mutual respect for each other and sound relationship between the brothers and sisters are some influences on the child's mind. Urban children of working parents have to depend on home workers and relatives as well. Father and mother of such family are unable to give necessary time for the children is taking their food, learning lessons, playing, or other kinds of recreation. As a consequence, these children do not get proper socialization. Various causes create barrier to proper socialization of children. Some of these are disorder in the family, divorce or separation between parents, or accommodation at different places, death of one or both of the parents, etc. These children suffer a lot. They pick up loneliness, vengeance, escaping attitude, self-centeredness, lack of shyness, cleverness, etc. And these are expressed in their behavior. That is why we have to be careful so that our families are free from these problems. So our role is vital in socialization of children. In many cases, proper socialization of a child is also hindered due to too much authoritarian attitude of father or too much affectionate attitude of the mother. Therefore, coordination of behavior of parents and other family members should be done to build up the behavior and attitude of children. This kind of coordination can ensure a proper control over a child's growth of behavioral pattern. As a result, the child will grow up as a self-conscious personality. That was all from my side. With this, we have completed chapter 3. Now, there are two CQ questions as sample. And this type of questions you will get in the exam hall. The second one. And sample question MCQ. This type of MCQ questions will come in exams. Now, time for home task. Please complete this home task and upload your answer in the website. The question is distinguish between nuclear and joint families. This is a very important question. It often comes in the exams. Now let us enjoy a video clip regarding coronavirus awareness. With this, we have come to an end of today's lecture. Hope you have understood whatever I have discussed till now. And thank you very much for being with me. See you in the next class. Till then, Allah Hafiz.